Alrighty, I want to say welcome everyone to our Harverst Term 2 Welcome Week celebration here at Eastfield College, part of the Eastfield Campus next to the Dallas College District. And again, we want to say thank you for coming out to our student engagement, meet our student engagement staff. So if you're watching this recording or looking at it now, we want to say welcome back, or welcome to your first semester for the fall semester for fall 2020. So starting off with a little bit, today's PowerPoint presentation is going to be more about student life and student engagement and what we here at Eastfield College have to offer you. So starting off with some etiquette rules and just things to keep in mind as we're going through here. If you happen to have any questions or concerns, we ask that you mute your mic unless you are speaking. We hugely suggest that you use the chat box feature to ask any questions. And also, as of right now, our closed caption feature is now active. So if you're in need or in benefit of that, please make sure to look at the bottom of the screen as you notice the words going across the screen for closed caption. Next up, this event is being recorded. So since we are virtual, we ask that if you're needing to come back to this presentation or did not have a chance to be with us live, we ask that you come back to this team site, go over the files tab and actually look over this content. So Pat, last but not least, use your gifts in the chat box feature. We really want to stay engaged. We know we're in a virtual space, but that's the whole point of student life and student engagement. Still having that connections, even in times we can't physically be next to each other. So starting off with, let's meet your hosts. My name is Jide Kuru. I am one of the program coordinators here on campus out of our student life office. I run some of our programs in regards to clubs and orgs, and I'm going to pass it off to my teammate, Jessica.
Hi, my name is Jessica Sierra. I am a program service assistant, and please let me know if you ever need any help.
Cool. Next up, we have I think we might have Angie Rivera on the line as well, and she probably is going to go over a little bit. Angie, you there?
I'm here. I just couldn't hear you. You cut off, so I was waiting for you to finish. Hello, everyone. My name is Angie Rivera, and I am for both student life and engagement, as well as educational partnerships. I am excited for you all to get to know us and learn more about us so that you can stay engaged during your educational college journey.
Cool. And last but not least, we also have Cindy Fabella on the call. That's our other teammate on the call. So you might be able to get some emails from her in regards to like our prizes and our giveaways, but that makes up our student engagement team. So starting off with Angie, you want to kick us off?
Yes, so for our student involvement, we have a mission statement that we go off of so that you can, like I said, be engaged with us and feel acclimated to the college itself, as well as like with us. And so we go off of a mission statement as to why we do it. I am not going to read the entire thing, but as you can see it here on the screen, I've highlighted, I feel like a good intricate part of why we do what we do, and it's so that we provide Eastfield students with the opportunity to develop self-awareness and identity through experiential learning, creative campus programming, exposure to diverse cultures, and building campus affinity. As I have said, we are here for you. Whatever that you may want to see more of, want to do, please let us know. We work for you all in making sure that you enjoy your time while you're with Dallas College.
Cool. Thanks, Angie, for that little tidbit. So you might be wondering if this is what we do, where do we do it from? So to get a little bit more understanding of where we are and how it goes about, we got Jessica.
So next slide, please. So we are located in C216, but with campus being closed for some areas, you can reach us virtually. Our office number is, our virtual hours are from Monday to Friday from 9 a.m. to 5 p.m. Our office number is 972-391-1099. And our email is the number 4, studentlife@bccd.edu. Please note that you can also visit our Microsoft Teams page. You will simply just have to search Eastfield Campus Virtual Events, and that is where we will mostly host our virtual events. Our programming consists of academic enrichment, campus-wide events, clubs and orgs, cultural events, and we are also home of Motley, intramural leadership development, and Student Government Association.
Cool. Thanks, Jess. So again, though we are virtual in this time period, we ask that you still stay connected and get a hold of us so that way we can have that connection. If it's your first time in college, your returning student who just kind of wants to know about campus and some of the activities we have planned for you all. So speaking of activities, first off, we have our campus-wide events. So normally what happens during this time period, it's about to be our Halloween festival. We have homecoming happening. We've also already had like some of our heritage months, which we'll talk about later. But all these events that we typically do on campus, we are still doing virtually. So for example, for the last 2 months, we've been celebrating our heritage months. And for this upcoming week, we still have our virtual homecoming. So this is not just a campus-based event, but this is a college-wide event, which includes some fun virtual concerts as well as some watch parties. But typically we have our welcome week events, our stress busters, our presidential award at the end of the spring semester, and even our thrilling Thursdays. So during this time period, we always try to keep our students engaged so you know what's going on and you feel more of that student life experience during your college journey. So talking about one of our first programs, we have academic enrichment.
Yes, so for academic enrichment, it's one of my specialties in the Student Life and Engagement Office. So for academic enrichment, it's basically all of the educational stuff that we try to bring to life, whether it's with the faculty or just something that we celebrate every year. I think I got sidetracked. We have our common book that I am over, and so last year we read over spare parts, and so we did different things like bring the tech truck with us and did different various activities and events regarding to the book. This year we are reading Tornado Season, and the author was an Eastfield College alumni, so that is pretty amazing. And so we're doing at the moment different virtual events as far as having like a book club reading or having quests where students can do different activities and win a prize pack at the end of the month. And then we also have like scholarship information that we have. Scholars Day, if you wanted to do an undergraduate research study and be recognized for it, we also have that. And then another big event that we host is International Education Week. During this week, we just kind of like to promote study abroad opportunities that you may have. I understand that right now it's kind of difficult to do so, but we're still celebrating it because once it becomes normal, we will go back to giving that information to you all. We also host things like Constitution Day, celebrating specific educational holidays, and as well as having stress busters events for finals whenever you're tired and you want something new, something different, and just try to relax. We give you those activities where you're able to either draw or de-stress doing a workout, as well as like finding recipes on a trail mix. Anything like that, we have it in our area with academic enrichment. And like I said, if there's something that you don't see you would like to add, by all means, please come to me and I will be happy to organize and plan that out for our students.
Cool. Thanks, Angie. So next up, we have some of our cultural heritage programming. Jessica, you want to tell us a little bit about it?
Actually, so we also have cultural heritage programming. And which, for example, we had our Hispanic and Latinx Heritage Month last week. our finale last week featuring Diane Guerrero. And we also had Dolores Huerta come in and encourage everyone to vote. For example, we have a event tomorrow for LGBTQ plus Heritage Month, which is LGBT 101 ally training. So we just focus on Heritage Month as well. If you have anything you would want to see happen, feel free to reach out and we'll see what we can do.
Yeah, so like Jessica was saying, we understand the huge diversity of our student population, from age to culture to creed, and even identity. So we try to make sure that we're celebrating that your month is celebrated throughout the entire year. And we try to give our other students an opportunity to learn and grow throughout the month. So if you have more questions about how to find out more about Heritage Month, you can find it on our DCCCD website. And right now, if you type in LGBTQ, the full agenda of events will happen even now during virtual events. So next up, so there's a lot of things we want to get you to do, and sometimes you're like, this is cool and all, but I'm more about looking for that student interaction and that student connection. And we understand that now even more than before that, you're really trying to get, how can you connect to new students and make some new friends if you're in this virtual space? So one of the things we want to let you know about is our clubs and organizations. So we range from different types of clubs and organizations that we have. We have things from our anime club, our communication club, to even like our women's empowerment and men's student brotherhood. If there's a club you're interested in, or you really just have a passion and you're trying to see who else is interested in it, you can actually create your own club and org. So I serve as the club and org coordinator here on campus. And one of the things that we're looking for, you have to have at least 10 members to kind of be on the same page as you. And we can walk through some of those details. Now we understand that it's a little harder during this time. So sometimes even though you don't have all the members, you still want to know what it takes to be a club and org. Just stop on by, send me an email, and we can talk a little bit more about how to get you connected to some of the other clubs on our campus and college-wide as well. But speaking specifically campus-wise, we are the home of Motley. Jessica, who's Motley?
So Motley is our mascot, our Eastfield mascot. And even though we are one college, each campus has a mascot. And once campus opens up, please feel free to be on the lookout for a sign-up sheet to be Motley. Okay, I'm stopping with the B puns.
But yeah, so Motley is our own mascot, and your new favorite colors should be maybe blue and orange. That's not a bad combination. But yeah, you might see Motley buzzing around through our campus. And we just hope that during the games and things like that, you get to be part of our student life and also get to be part of our school spirit. So speaking about spirit and engagement, we have our intramural sports and recreation. So we understand that sometimes you need to be active, and our intramural sports program is broken down into three different categories. We have our competitive sports, we have our recreational sports, and then we also have our fitness-based activities. So when it comes down to, as you can see before, last two years, we've had our intramural volleyball tournament for homecoming week. We won't be able to do that next week, but we look forward to next year to have the students versus faculty and staff volleyball game. During this time period, since we're unable to do physical activities, we have shifted to online activities such as our live and video-led activities in terms of workouts on our Workout Wednesday, which is every other Wednesday. We also have activities that are leading more during our stress busters, like Angie talked about earlier. These events are more focused towards centering yourself, getting your breathing right, and helping you get rid of some of the test anxieties and have some more healthy based options in terms of food and lifestyle. So if you're interested in our student sport, in our intramural sports and recreation, just go ahead and hit us up. And again, at our For Student Life at DCCCD email. Again, you see all our contact information at the end of this PowerPoint. So going up next, I think we got SGA. Oh, wow. So you might be wondering, what's SGA? For those of you who are freshmen in college, SGA is our Student Government Association. So this is where you as a student have the opportunity to voice your concerns and some of the changes you want to see happen on campus. So some of the things that happen to be a member of our SGA association is that you have to be currently enrolled as a student. We're looking for students who are interested in voting and also taking that leadership role in terms of being a member, being a voice for your peers. If you're interested in that, the contact information for the advisor of the club is Alex Snowden. It's located on the current PowerPoint presentation. And you can hit us up a little more to know a little bit more about how you as a student can have an active role in shaping the college-wide experience. Next up, we got an app.
Eastfield has an app. You can access our virtual office, our clubs and orgs, as well as our events calendar. You can also interact with other students and professors. I've seen students post that they are selling a book, and I've also seen students ask the question about a certain course, and I've seen the professor respond to it. So feel free to download the app. It's available in the Google Play Store as well as the Apple App Store.
Yeah, it's especially during this virtual time, Jessica, you're definitely hitting on something right there, because this is where, again, you're able to see all the events we have campus-wide and college-wide. This is the best and quickest ways to get interactions from other students and us faculty and staff as well. Again, we really encourage you to download the app to find out and stay connected with us on campus. But staying connected with us on campus, Angie, where else can they find us if they need us?
So if you wanted to stay engaged and informed, please follow us at our Instagram page. And on there, we do posts as well as stories. If you ever wanted to interact or maybe even take over for a day, we'd be open for that. Just kind of show us a day in a life during virtual times. That would be awesome. We also have our Twitter at Eastfield_SL, which would be student life. If you ever wanted to just tweet us or share information, by all means, we have it there. And then we have our YouTube, and our name is 4 Student Life. And on there, we host videos for our intramurals, and or we post events that have already happened. For instance, we just got through finishing up with our Hispanic and Latinx month. And so if you wanted to go see some of the events that we hosted, some of the things that we did, like how to make a salsa or tune in to find out like the correct terminology, go on there and we'll show the recordings of our events. I can't guarantee all of them, so if you can show up, by all means, please do so. But if you don't have time, YouTube is there. And then we also have our Facebook, and it's Dallas College Eastfield Campus, and on there you'll just get more information and resources that we have available to you as a student or as a community member.
Cool.
And that will, believe, conclude our presentation for today. Again, myself, Angie, JC, Jessica, and Cindy are here to help you throughout your educational journey, and hope that we can engage you in so many different ways, whether it's cultural, working out, or just attending events so that you can de-stress or just kind of enjoy and have fun with your friends. We are here for you.
All right. With that being said, thank you for everything.